Hello everyone, it's Carrie. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to back to another card in my holiday card series for 2016. Today we're going to be making this card here. I'm going to be using this Hero Art stamp set that you see already stamped out. I apologize that I went ahead and stamped out some of my images. I thought I had record on my camera and I did not. So that's why you see some of my elements are already complete, and I apologize for that, but as soon as I noticed I hit that record button and I'm going to continue on with my card here. So the wreath that you see there is from Hero Arts. It's called A Wreath of Leaves. And then I'm taking this stamp set here from Sunny Studio, and I'm going to ink up. There is a coordinating die with this set, and it is actually what they call a closed die. So it's easier for me anyway to go ahead and die cut the die first and then stamp down the image onto the cardstock to line it up. So that's what I'm doing, and I am first stamping down the bottom of the bulb. I'm using my Hippo ink from Lawn Fawn for that, and then I'm taking my black ink here. This is Black Licorice, also from Lawn Fawn. All of the inks that you see me using today are from Lawn Fawn, and I used a lot. So all of the ones that I did use, obviously, as always, I will go ahead and list them and link them below for you in case that you are interested in any of the colors that I used. So I'm continuing to go ahead and stamp out all of the bottom of these bulbs here, kind of like a assembly line style, if you will. And I'm going to get that all done. I'm doing six of these bulbs. And now I'm going to do what they call the Roy G. Biv rainbow effect of these. I decided whether I wanted to do like all red bulbs, or if I wanted to do a rainbow of colors. And I just decided to go ahead and do a rainbow, if you will, of colors for these bulbs, because I thought it would stand out the best on my card that I'm doing. So I'm first stamping this down with my lobster ink. And I'm getting that really good and inked up, and then stamping down as firmly as I can because it is a solid stamp. And I'm not using my Misty. Surprise, surprise. In every video, it seems like I've been using my Misty. But there's a good reason for that, because it's a really great tool to have in your craft room. But these inks, even though they start out splotchy, sometimes they do even out at the end whenever they soaked into the paper. So I'm not too worried about the inks that I was using. But I took a chili pepper here for the second portion of this stamp, and I'm holding it up here so you can see the dimension and how real the image looks. Really, really fun. Really fun design. I love this little stamp set. And I love the fact that this little stamp set is smaller, that it's got chock full of wonderful sentiments to use on your holiday and Christmas cards this year, or any year. But it's also got this image of the light bulb that you can create really fun accents with your sentiments. So I really do love this whole fall release that Sunny Studio has released this year. I've discovered them. I've always kind of seen them as a stamp company, but I really didn't paid too close attention, to be quite honest. But within the last few months, I really have paid attention to their stamps, and they're just so, I love the way that they design them, and just how simple they are. And it's really kind of hard to explain, but that's the best that I can do. So so that's why you've seen me use now two of their stamp sets in my series this year, because it's really, really a great release. So I've gone ahead and fast forwarded just a little bit here, so you didn't want to see all the stamping, because that would have taken a long time, and it did take me a little bit of time to do all the stamping. But you see all the bulbs that I have, got them all stamped out there. And now I'm taking my last few inks here, and I'm doing the purple bulb here. And I'm kind of seeing how I'm going to assemble all of these together. So I decided to go ahead and die cut my little wreath here with these. These are some older dies that I've had. These are from Spellbinders. They're just your basic scallop circle. And because I didn't have any other ones, I've been meaning to go ahead and get the ones from Lawn Fawn, but these work just as well too. So that's why I die cut this out. And you see how it's really fun. It looks like a real wreath there. So now I am wanting to take my Misty, only because I've got such a small area, and I did not want to redo this. So that's why I'm making sure that I'm going to get my sentiment lined up really, really well and get this stamped down, because I only want to make this card one time. So, and it seems like anytime that I do mess up, usually it's during the sentiment portion. So I've got that good and inked up, and you can see how that's going to stamp right there in the middle, and it's going to really complete the whole focal panel of my card for today. So I'm inking this up with one of my favorite black inks. This is the VersaFine Onyx Black Ink. It is a pigment ink, and you can use embossing powder with it if you like to. I usually do that if I want like a black embossed sentiment. I usually use this ink here and then clear embossing powder and then emboss it, as opposed to using like VersaMark ink and then stamping that down with black embossing powder. For some reason, black embossing powder is like one of the messier of the embossing powders. I never know why, but so anyway, so sidetrack there. Just FYI, if you're new to card making, the best way to do a black embossed sentiment, in my opinion, is to use the VersaFine Onyx Black with your clear embossing powder. So now I'm going to go ahead and assemble some of my lights here. And you see I've decided on joining the two bulbs together. And I thought this would be a really fun design to do that like this. And I've just taken some really small glue dots and I've adhered them together. And now I'm going to want to pop this up. So I've got some of these foam dots here. These are from Stampin' Up. These have been in my stash forever and a day, it seems. I've had these probably ever since I started stamping, which was back in 2009. And so, but I really do like these because they don't have too much bulk, but they're great size enough for what I'm using for them today. And the backings come off really, really easily too. So, and they're really just a really great adhesive. I mean, they really do stick. Once you get them stuck down to your project, they're not going to go anywhere. So that's why you see me not press down too hard right now. I'm just kind of placing them on where my project for the moment. I'm just kind of placing them there and seeing how I like everything before I actually give them a firm press down. I didn't want to commit right off the bat. So, but I do like how that is turning out. And then I am working on a little bow here. I'm going to save y'all the anguish of me trying to do this on camera. So that's why I've gone ahead and taken this and tied it off camera, because it takes me for, I don't know why, bows are just not my friend whenever I'm doing them on camera. So I thought I would go ahead and add a little bit of texture to my card base for today. This is from Summons to Stamp, this cardstock here, and I am going to take this stencil, also from Summons to Stamp. This is a Falling Snow stencil, and I'm just going to place some like post-it tape kind of on the edge there so it will protect part of the back of the card. And I'm going to take this ink here. This is Peacock, I believe, from Lawn Fawn, and I'm going to take my ink blending tool and just kind of go around and take that ink and press that into the stencil and just kind of turning it. As you can see there, I'm just kind of turning it as I go around on the stencil. I'm making sure I get a lot of good ink in those circles because I want this to be really prominent on the background of my card. A lot of this is going to be get covered up anyway from my little wreath here, but I didn't want it to leave just plain on the cardstock. So it gives it just a little bit of something in the background. Other than just the plain cardstock. So you can see how that's kind of turning out there. So now it's time to go ahead and add some foam adhesive on the back of my wreath. So I went ahead and placed all of my foam adhesive all around the circles as best as I could, and then remove all the backings. And now I'm going to go ahead and adhere that to my card base. And then what I'm going to do is add the bow here. So I'm going to take a couple more of my small glue dots and add that to the bow. And I'm just going to make sure that that's good and adhered and press down on there. So I like the double bow on this. I thought it really added to it, the design. And for a final touch, I'm going to take my Spectrum Noir glitter pen here. I don't usually use this one. I usually use the Winkostella, but I thought I would give this one a go for today and give a lot of shimmer to those lights and add some really fun shimmer. So that will complete our card for today, guys. I hope you really enjoyed the tutorial. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I'd love to have you to be a subscriber. And I will catch y'all in my next video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye-bye.